Well, I finally got the electrical build done on this box fan project. Everything is in there and hooked up and working correctly. The cover will go on that and hide it all. And the only thing I've added since yesterday's video is this little transformer right here. That's for standby. When it's when the fan is off, that transformer keeps the drive control power on so that the system's ready to respond to a start command. And then when you start it, this contactor down here will turn on the main transformer. And that's not necessary just to run the machine, but I want to leave it plugged in so that I can use the lights and convenience outlet. And that'll make sure that none of this is live when the fan is stopped. Because nobody should reach in there anyway, and they won't when the fan's running because of common sense. But with the fan stopped, I don't want those terminals live there. Okay, that is with the control cubicle covered up with the plywood cover. And what you see right now is pretty much all you're going to see when the fan has got the grills on it. If you go way down here, you can see just a little bit of the cooling fan, but no wiring, nothing hanging out. I put some it was old headliner material from a car left over on the bottom of that, and I forgot to take a picture to help absorb the sound of the little cooling fan. So I'll start the unit and see if it helped any. Maybe I hear that cooling fan, but maybe not. Yeah, I like it. That click at the end is when the main power transformer over there, the contactor, turns it off. With the cord mounted there and a strain relief, the little water pipe conduit comes in, goes back here, tees off for the transformer, comes up here for the low voltage side and underneath the cover, and then comes out there up to the control panel. Really no exposed wiring. It all looks very simple and not doesn't detract attention away from the fan itself, which is my goal after all for this whole build. And that's the entire electrical system done. So it's time to do a safety check on it. I have my meter set up for continuity buzzer mode, where it'll beep like that if I've got connection. And what I'm going to do, connect this to the ground pin or PE on the cord. So anything I touch that has continuity through to the ground pin, I'll get the tone on the meter. Every part of this thing that could in theory get shorted out and become electrically live and shock somebody should be grounded. And now that I've got the meter hooked up like this, if I touch something connected to ground, I'll get the tone. So of course the outlet ground points are good. The metal switches are grounded. That's everything up here that could maybe get shorted out and possibly shock someone is grounded. And that will make it basically trip a breaker instead of be an electrical hazard. Now I'll move on here to the actual fan. The only thing not painted on the fan is this little thumb screw, but it's rusted. Yeah, it's rusted, so it doesn't have good contact. Go down here to something better. So the fan itself is grounded. The power transformer, thanks to the guy that messed it up in shipping, I got a bare spot to test right there. And now the work lights, believe it or not, those have an aluminum body. Got a continuity to ground there and there. And one last part, the cord holder is aluminum, and that is grounded. So that tells me my build electrically is safe, and I don't have to worry about any kind of stray voltages, since this is mains powered, and on top of that, the transformer boosts it up to 4 times mains voltage, so got to be especially careful. Then come around here, and you saw that yesterday, plus I've got the wood sealer on it to make it a little glossy. And then on the front, the front grille is done, painted with the green Rust-Oleum. Put back on. And I did use the fan's work lights for that. I was painting the grill right here over those jack stands, and the work lights were very effective. So this thing is coming along. It's almost done. Only thing yet that I'm not sure how I'm going to do is the rear grill motor trim ring, because I want to have a big round ring welded into that grill, because the motor actually sticks out a little bit beyond the back of the fan. And I'm going to think about that while I'm at work this time, and maybe when I come back I'll have a way to cut something precisely that'll work for that. Give it another start up here. That is a smooth motor. All right, guys, thanks again, and I will update this project as time permits.